Space, the final frontier. These are the voyages of the Starship Enterprise. Its continuing mission, to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations,
to boldly go where no one has gone before. You see, I must have heard that phrase maybe 1,000 times. In fact, it's something I've heard maybe every day of my life. And if not that, some other phrase from the show that it originates from. Now, before I explain my own experiences with this subject matter, we need to establish some context.
Yeah, Spider-Man and Freeze in full effect.
You ready, Ron?
I'm ready.
You ready, Dave?
I'm ready, Slick. Are you?
Oh, yeah. Take it down.
Our story starts with a young teen sitting in front of his television set every Monday night and catching the latest episode of Star Trek, The Next Generation. That young teen would become my dad. Ever since then, my father has been obsessed with Star Trek. My father even almost skipped out on his high school graduation rehearsal to see an important interview of the cast during their penultimate season. And during my parents' honeymoon in Las Vegas, they took some time to do the Star Trek experience, which my father remembers vividly, and my mom, not so much. So it should be no surprise that Star Trek was an important part of my childhood. However, it wasn't that simple. My father decided to show my sibling and me every single episode of Star Trek in order of release. However, at the time, my sibling was considerably older than me. They were able to understand the nuances of the characters and how they reflected the human condition. Meanwhile, I was bored out of my mind until the piece was not enough and the Enterprise needed to lock phasers. It also didn't help that at the time I started watching Star Trek, I was deeply obsessed with Star Wars. Now, if you know anything about both of these fictional universes, you must know that there is a deep division between them. On one side of the debate, you have a story of an epic battle between good and evil, and on the other side, you have a discussion on morals and ethics as humans explore what they have yet to understand. Both extremely different, yet little to no compromise upon what side to choose. So naturally, as a 7-year-old I was, I drew closer to the fighting and adventure that Star Wars brought to the table. Now fast forward around 10 years. A 16-year-old kid sits in front of his flat-screen television with his family every weeknight and watches a streamed episode of Star Trek The Next Generation. That kid is me. After years of proclaiming my love for Star Wars, I wanted to understand the importance of Star Trek, especially as I drew near the age my father was when he first watched it. So I sat down, told my family I wanted to watch it for real this time, and now I can say that I understand. I know these characters. Picard is someone with power yet vulnerability, and Data is a character that can do anything but fit in. And I'm also glad to understand the stories that they are put in, and how they reflect the flaws of how we live today. However, trying to explain its importance would not be my strong suit. I feel like you would need decades of experience to do so. Luckily, I know someone who does.
So, my favorite Star Trek character would have to be Data, the android from Star Trek The Next Generation series. I think Data is a mirror to humanity, and it was somebody who we could kind of see ourselves through him as he discovered what it meant to be human, because he couldn't experience any emotions. I always found that fascinating, that that's what the human condition is, what he always strived to understand and try to emulate. So yeah, I would say Data. I think the way I've found myself represented in Star Trek is having a positive outlook. The world around us, especially the past couple years, and throughout my life as I look back on it, seeing myself through Star Trek is seeing optimism that things will get better. Because Star Trek is all about humanity and in the future leaving Earth and exploring. So I think just the outlook, just the positive that it's gonna get better. So growing up watching it, science fiction just in general, I like that aspect of it, the technology. But then the more I watched it, the more I realized the storytelling. Even though it's trying to represent, you know, what life is like 400 years from now, seeing those stories and getting so drawn into them and the characters, because I love it so much, you want to share it with people. And naturally, you want to share it with your family. And because it's something that you can watch as a child, so showing it to my kids when they were younger, them saying, oh, wow, that character's exciting, this is cool, then continuing to watch it, and as they got older, understanding, oh wow, there's some storytelling going on here, or there's some characterization. And then what's interesting is I'm watching it now with my children again, maybe, you know, 10 years after the first time I showed it to them, and them looking at it and going, wow, that was amazing. We'll pause the episode and we'll talk about, you know, man, they're really touching on race relations, or they're really, you know, touching on poverty. It's incredible. So to have that, a draw that Star Trek can have is a kind of a sci-fi adventure that kids could get into, but then growing with it and understanding the much deeper themes that are in the show. So. You know, I talked earlier about being very optimistic, but it's hard. I've had recent conversation with some friends and family included. What do we need as a society, as a global community? What do we need to happen where we do come together? Star Trek's big, you know, turning point was what they call First Contact, where an alien species actually finally lands on Earth and shakes a hand of a human and says, you're not alone. So you think of that as this great turning point, but then in this future history of Star Trek, after that, you know, there were still wars, there was still, you know, famine. So it's not like that was a turning point in the answer, but I'm scared by what's, you know, happening. I want to be optimistic. I want to think that, you know, we can get there and we can do it. When I see younger people and I see taking political action where they haven't before, caring, that gives me some hope. I've never seen this country, the United States, so divided as it has been. But that can be good, because when it's that heavily divided, the sides are much easier to see. And it's, you know, are you gonna choose this path? Or are you gonna choose this path? And I think that my kids and young people in general, you know, wanna choose the right path and wanna go down a road where we can accept our differences, work together, and move towards something like Star Trek, but yeah. I think the true importance of Star Trek is, that's a great question, I don't know. I think the importance of Star Trek is just really good storytelling about the human condition, showing us where we've been, where we are, and where we're going. And there's hope in a better tomorrow.
That's good. Thanks, Dad.
You're welcome.
All right. So originally I had this passage written out in the early stages of making this documentary, one where I guessed what my father would say in this interview. However, after editing, I realized I never understood the true passion he had for Star Trek. He's able to speak with such wisdom and can apply the things he learned from Star Trek to problems of today, which gives me, what he put simply, a lot of hope for our future. So from here on out, we should continue to listen to these stories and how we can all learn from them. And I guess that's the importance of Star Trek.
Blue skies smiling at me, nothing but blue skies do I see. Blue birds.